RJD sir, good morning sir.
Yeah, good morning.
First of all, let me extend my heartfelt thanks to our honorable commissioner Sri M.M. Nayak garu for providing a wonderful opportunity to conduct this kind of webinars and all. Now, our RJD sir, a dynamic personality who is an inspiring role model for us, with your inspiration, with your the positive attitude we have imbibed, with that spirit we have started this kind of the programs. Thank you so much sir for inspiring us continuously for doing this kind of the webinars. I welcome today's the speaker, the Professor Jonalagada Venkateshwara garu, on behalf of the college, entire college. I welcome our beloved principal Dr. P. Venkatrao garu and vice principal Dr. P. Lata and mathematics faculty B. Vinila. Welcome you all and my dear participants. A very good morning one and all. First of all, let me introduce the today's speaker, then we can followed by our honorable RJD sir speech. Let me introduce the today's speaker. Jonalagada Venkateshwara Rao is a professor in algebra, Department of Mathematics, and a Senate member at United States International University, Africa, Nairobi, Kenya. His academic career spanning more than 28 years in teaching and research as well. Professor Rao is a professor since 2007. He worked as a professor at Mekelle University, Ethiopia, East Africa from 2009 to 2019. Prior to that, he worked as a professor in India for 2 years. He was awarded Best Educationist by International Institute of Education and Management, New Delhi. Professor Jonalagada Venkateshwara Rao has an outstanding academic career spanning over 28 years in teaching and research. He graduated PhD in the year 2001. He obtained his postgraduate from Andhra University. He did his doctorate in mathematics in the field of algebra. He did his graduation at Hindu College, Guntur. After joining the PG program at Andhra University, the lectures by Professor U. M. Swami and Professor P. Rangarao garu to lead him to research in algebra, in fact, in lattice theory. Further, in 1991-92, Professor J.V. Rao did his MPhil degree in regular stream and Tamil Nadu, India, and was inspired towards a teaching of PG courses by the able guidance of Professor K. Chandrasekhar Rao garu. Professor Rao has in his credit more than 150 research papers in India in international reputed journals. He is a peer reviewer scientific research journals from 2010. He was appointed as a technical editor for Asian Journal of Algebra, Asian Journal of Mathematics and Statistics, Asian Journal of Applied Science, and Journal of Trends in Applied Science Research. Professor Rao upheld the legacy of eminent professors N.V. Subramaniam, Professor U.N. Swami, and Professor I.R.B. Sharma, Professor Y.V. Reddy, and Professor P. Koteshwara Rao. By carrying the research in algebra, and he has produced more than 20 PhDs in the Department of Mathematics. He has published more than 150 papers, research papers, in various national and international journals. During his 28 years of teaching experience, Professor Rao rendered his service in various positions. With this welcome note, I welcome you all. Now I request our honorable RJD sir, please address the today's participants. Thank you so much sir, thank you.
Very good morning to all of you, and thanks for inviting me. Thank you. Welcoming all the teacher delegates, student delegates, and today's guest speaker, Professor Rao, the principal of the college, Venkat Rao, and IKAC coordinators, head of the Department of Mathematics, TDC Narasimhapatnam. And it's a great privilege for me to address on this occasion. And thanks for inviting me to address today. Because today I have so many webinars to address, because today's importance, this 17th September, is a very important day for mathematics students, because it's today's specialty is it is Riemann's birthday. It's Riemann's birthday. I think all the mathematics world knows about Professor Riemann. Is a great mathematician. He's a German mathematician. The Riemann is a German mathematician. We are all known. He's a well-known great mathematician in the history of mathematics. So he was born in 1826. He lived only for 40 years. He lived only for 40 years, 1826 to 66. He lived only for 40 years, but he made extraordinary contribution in the field of mathematics. So Riemann made extraordinary contribution. The students, especially those who are interested in mathematics and wants to move towards and love mathematics. So these students should know about Riemann's history. So we all know very well, Riemann is famous for Riemann integrals in real analysis. Generally, we appreciate Riemann, because Riemann integral is his concept and his theory. Riemann integral in real analysis, generally everybody knows. A degree student who is mathematics student knows very well about Riemann. But Riemann made extraordinary contributions, see, in analysis, algebra, and number theory. And nowadays, if you see the technology, the technological side, if you look into that, cryptology, cryptography is completely depending on the number theory. So I think Riemann's contributions might have been extraordinarily used even at cryptology. So Riemann. Is a 150-year-old problem. In 1850s, they announced that it is called Riemann hypothesis. So Riemann hypothesis is nothing but as Riemann zeta function has its zeros only at the negative even integers, and complex numbers are having value. A real part is 12, something like that. So Riemann hypothesis unsolved conjecture unsolved. For the 150 years. So it is actually $1 million prize question. Who has solved the problem? It is $1 million, he will get $1 million. So that means it is 7 crores 50 lakhs and above in Indian currency. 7 crores 50 lakhs and above. It's $1 million question. But Sir Michael Atiyah. Sir Michael Atiyah. See, many great mathematicians made an attempt for Riemann hypothesis. The world problems is of just like even Fermat's last theorem or Poincaré's conjecture, whatever it may be. So these two, over and above this Riemann hypothesis, is extraordinarily difficult problem. That's what they said, because it's involved with number theory. It's completely involved with number theory and a lot of. If you Google it, you will get a lot of information about Riemann hypothesis. So it's a $1 million question, $1 million prize question. So recently, Sir Michael Atiyah is a British mathematician who already won Fields Medal and as well as Abel's Prize. These two are very prestigious medals, the prestigious prizes for great mathematicians in the world, who made extraordinary contribution to mathematics in mathematics. So Fields Medal will be awarded below 40 years of age for a mathematician who made a contribution, great contribution. Similarly, Abel's Prize. These are extraordinary. It's like a Fields Medal is like a Nobel Prize, right, for mathematicians. So he has declared that he got the solution for Riemann hypothesis in 2020. So maybe now it has to be verified. The solution has to be verified, and if it is correct, and then the Riemann hypothesis will be declared that it is solved. So like this, Riemann has made extraordinary contribution. He's a great mathematician, he's a German mathematician, who made extraordinary contribution within the 40 years of his lifetime. And then the students and the teacher delegates to mathematics, who love mathematics. So you should know about the history of mathematics, what our previous great mathematicians made contributions. And at present, the entire world is enjoying the science and technology. If you look into that, it's a base is mathematics. So these all, even Riemann also made a contribution for the present technology. So like this, the great mathematicians are there. So like this, and we are today remembering the Riemann's greatest contribution in mathematics, especially in everybody aware Riemann known for analysis, right, and differential geometry. But the number theory also made extraordinary contribution. That's what the Riemann hypothesis is now. So this is a few remarks about on this occasion. But anyway, we are going to have a guest speaker, Professor Rao, is going to deliver on something algebras, star algebra, something like that. It might be. It seems to be. It is also extraordinary work. The deliberations and today's in the today's international webinar organized by the GDC RC Patnam will go in a smooth manner. I wish all the best and thanks for giving this opportunity. And then I wish many more this kind of, every department should organize this kind of webinars. And keeping remembering the great scientists, mathematicians. See, even this Riemann, I read at some place in the history of mathematics that even Riemann made extraordinary, Riemann's work is also extraordinarily used in the relativity theory of Einstein. I don't know how it's linked with that, but the history will inspire us. So why today Riemann's birthday is celebrating, why we are celebrating Riemann's birthday? So because we are just remembering the hit's greatest contribution in mathematics, and today everybody is enjoying. The entire world is enjoying the science and technology, and in all parts of the world, in all parts of the sciences and social sciences, even including economics, everything, everywhere, all parts of the science and technology. So he's being extraordinarily developed. And so all the scientists, see, if you look at the technological side, even the cyber technology, even the cryptology. The cryptography is used in defense generally. The cryptography, cryptology will be used in the defense. It has been started in Julius Caesar's time, in 16th century, in cryptography. It's been begun by the Julius Caesar, then the king, Julius Caesar. But after that, the cryptography has been developed, and mathematicians took the idea, and then even our Ramanujan, our great mathematician of our Indian nation, so also made extraordinary contribution. So thank you very much for the few remarks on this occasion. And once again, I wish you all the best, and the deliberations will go in a smooth manner. Thank you very much for giving us.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your wonderful message to all participants. Thank you so much. With your words, we have a lot of inspiration. Thank you. We will move further. Now I request our honorable principal, sir.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you very much, sir. RJD Garu, today is about Riemann's birthday. Thank you. Thank you, Honor. Thank you, sir. I would like to welcome you all to the international webinar on over the algebra organized by Government Degree College, Narsipatnam. In the space of 2 weeks, we were able to organize. For this, I would like personally thank to the Honorable Commissioner, Sri Namuru, I Naik Garu, IAS, and Honorable RJD, Sir David Kumar Garu, to give a wonderful speech for this occasion, for this continuous support. Maths as a topic is continuously evolving, and webinars like these from speakers like Professor J. Venkateswara Garu, former from School of Science and Technology, United States International, Nairobi, Kenya, help to understand these new developers in a broader and new fashion. I hope all the participants get to enjoy these understanding webinars, and wish to organize more such webinars in the future. Last, I would like to thank my faculty for organizing the webinar in this manner, and our staff members. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your message. I request our Vice Principal, ma'am, Dr. P. Lata. Madam, please say a few words.
Good morning, respected Commissioner sir, RJD sir, our principal, faculty members, resource person, and all the participants. It's my privilege to take part in this international webinar, Vector Space over Pre-Algebra. It is a great privilege that is given to us to organize such an international webinar on this platform by our commissionerate and our commissioner sir. It's our blessing to have our RJD sir in our midst today. He is a renowned personality, a learned man, a man who encourages us and who guides us to organize such programs in the college level for the development of the student community. We thank our RJD sir immensely for his encouragement. I take this privilege to thank our principal sir, who is the backbone of our college, who leads us and who always encourages us and guides us to take our college to greater heights, the place. I take this opportunity to thank our resource person, Professor Janal Gadda. We are privileged to have you. We learn from you by your talk. Thank you for taking your time and coming on this program to enrich our students and the faculty members. Thank you very much, sir. I now take this privilege to thank our organizing committee member, Sri G. Srinivas Garu, who is our IQCIT coordinator and who always supports us to bring up different programs for our college. And last but not the least, but I would like to congratulate even the mathematics department, Vinila Garu also, for taking up such a program, so that many of them will be enlightened by this international webinar. I thank all the participants, and I thank our principal sir, RJD sir, and commissioner sir for giving me this opportunity to take part in this international webinar. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your nice words. Now I request Vinila ma'am, Department of Mathematics.
Good morning, Honorable Commissioner sir, Sri M.M. Nayak Garu, respected RJD sir, Dr. R. David Kumar Garu, our principal sir, Dr. P. Venkatrao Garu, Vice Principal Madam, Dr. P. Lata Garu, IQAC Coordinator, Sri G. Srinivas Rao Garu, Resource Person, Dr. Janal Gadda Venkateswar Rao Garu, and all my participants. Oh, we would like to take this opportunity. We would like to take this opportunity to place on record our heartly thanks to our Commissioner sir for giving us this opportunity to conduct this international webinar on Vector Space over Pre-A* Algebra. We also extend our thanks to our RJD sir for encouraging and inspiring us to conduct this program. We would like to thank our Principal sir for this cooperation to host this event. We also wish to express our gratitude to our Vice Principal Madam for being our support. We must mention our deep sense of appreciation to our IQAC coordinator for inviting a famous resource person. A big thank you to our resource person for accepting our invitation and for expressing his view on vector space over pre-A star algebra. Finally, we want to thank our faculty members and all the participants for different colleges. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Vinayala ma'am, for your opening remarks. Thank you. Now I request for the today's speaker, the eminent personality in the Department of Mathematics, Professor Yanlagada Venkateshwara garu.
Hello. I thank the organizers of this webinar. So first, I should thank the Special Commissioner M.M. Naik, IAS College Education, Andhra Pradesh, the Regional Joint Director, or David Kumar of Rajamahendra Varam, and Dr. P. Venkat Rao, Principal, Government Degree and PG College, C. Patnam, Dr. P. Lata Garu, Vice Principal, Government Degree and PG College, Narsipatnam, and Dr. G. Srinivas Rao, IQAC Coordinator, and Srimati B. Vinila Garu, Lecturer in Mathematics, and this webinar coordinator as well. I sincerely thank them for organizing this event. So with this few welcoming remarks, I will continue my presentation. And the topic is the vector spaces over pre-A star algebras. So first, I would like to share you the abstract of this topic. So in this manuscript, the notion of vector space is initiated over pre-A star algebra. This article discusses the basic properties of pre-A star vector spaces, the notion of norm and their useful characterizations. And the keywords we are using in this concept are the notion of pre-A star algebra, pre-A star vector space, normed pre-A star vector space, Boolean pre-A star ring, R module, pre-A star metric space, and Boolean semi-ring. And first, I will introduce the concept by giving the historical background. First, Fernando and etc. originated the notion of C algebra, where C algebra is the algebraic structure you are observing here, where A is a non-empty set with two binary operations, meet and join, and this is a unary operation, and an equational three-valued generalization of Boolean algebra based on logic functions R and not. So this is the operation called meet, and this is the join, and this is the complementation, but not exactly complementation, but this is a unary operation. So where these operations are nothing but based on the Boolean algebra logic functions like R and not. In case of Boolean algebra, this is complementation. And later, Mainz introduced the notion of ADA. ADA means algebra of disjoint alternatives. And you are observing the structure of the ADA here. So where A is a non-empty set and meet and join are the binary operations. And this dash pi are the unary operations. And 0, 1, 2 are the distinguished elements. So this is the structure based on the previous C algebra. So from C algebra structure, we are observing the ADA of the algebra of disjoint alternative structure. So you can observe the extension of the unary operations and the distinguished elements also mentioned here. And later on, Kotteswara Rao initiated the concept of A star algebra. So you can observe here the structure of A star algebra, where A is a non-empty set, meet and join are the binary, and also this star is also a binary operation, meet, join, star, three binary operations, and tilde and pi are the unary operations, and 0, 1, 2 are the distinguished elements. So you can observe from the C algebra, the first one is C algebra structure, The second one is the ADA structure, and the third one is A-star algebra structure. So Koteswar Rao initiated the concept of A-star algebra with this structure and studied the equivalence of this A-star algebra with the above C algebra and the ADA, and also he studied its link with three ring. So you should ask me, what is a three ring? Three ring is a generalization of Boolean ring, where we say Boolean ring is having a characteristic 2, and here the characteristic of three ring is 3. So in case of Boolean ring, A square is A for all A. Here A cube is A for all A, and it is of characteristic 3. So if you have the idea of a Boolean ring, then you can just extend the concept with 3. And later, Venkateswara Rao introduced the notion of three-A-star algebra, where A is a non-empty set, and meet and join are the two binary, and one is the unary operation. And this structure is nothing but a reductor of the above. The structure, three-A-star algebra structure, is a reductor of, reductor means we can take the same set, and the set of operations meet, join, tilde, or the subset of the above operations. So in such case, we mentioned that the below structure is nothing but the reductor of A-star algebra, and this structure is similar to the C algebra. This structure is similar to the C algebra. And later, Satyanarayana, etc., studied the partial ordering on pre-A-star algebras. So partial order concept they have studied, and later Venkateswara Rao documented the notion of congruence on pre-A-star algebra. So congruence means equivalence relation with the property that the equivalence relation should preserve the properties of, it should preserve the properties of the given algebra. So such a one is called congruence relation. So the congruence relations are also studied. And now we can see here in the next slide. Just wait. Yes. Now you can see the important points mentioned here. The concept of vector space over Boolean algebras initiated by Subramaniam is the motivation to the present study. And further, Subramaniam initiated the link between Boolean vector spaces with Boolean semirings. And the present manuscript that provides you the vector spaces over pre-A-star algebra. And roughly speaking, a pre-A-star vector space is a vector space in which the scalars are the elements of pre-A-star algebra. The scalars we have taken from pre-A-star algebra to define the pre-A-star vector space. And let me continue my discussion. First, we start with the definition of pre-A-star algebra. So let us see, the definition is there. Suppose the pre-A-star algebra structure, you can already we have discussed A meet join. So a pre-A-star algebra is a system with the structure A non-empty set, and meet and join are the binary, and this is the unary operation tilde. So the system satisfies for all x, y, z in A the following axioms. The first one is the double tilde rule. That means x tilde tilde. That means x double tilde is x. And the second one is the idempotent rule with respect to meet. That means x meet x is equal to x. And the third one is the commutativity with respect to meet. X meet y is equal to y meet x. And the fourth one is the De Morgan's law. So x meet y whole tilde is x tilde join y tilde. So this is De Morgan's law. And the fifth one is the associative rule with respect to meet. So x meet of y meet z is equal to x meet y meet z. And the next one, sixth one, is nothing but the distributivity of meet over join. So x meet y join z is equal to x meet y join x meet z. And the last one is the representation of the two elements. So we represent x meet y as x meet x tilde join y. So this is we use to represent the meet of the two elements. So this is the basic definition of pre-ester algebra. And in the next slide, you are observing an example for the pre-ester algebra. We have considered a three-element set. So the three-element set named as 3 is the set consisting of 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. And this set is defined by using the binary operations meet and join and the tilde. So the meet operation you are observing here. So you are observing meet and join in with respect to 0 and 1. We are getting like Boolean elements because 0 and 1 are the basis for the Boolean algebra. So 0 and 1 you are observing. You are observing like Boolean. The output is nothing but Boolean like elements. They are like Boolean elements in case of meet and join. Okay, in case of 0 and 1 only. But in case of 2, if you input is 2, the result is 2, it is defined like that. The input, if you 2 is inserted here, 2 meet of anything is resulted as 2, and 2 join any element is resulted as 2, and 2 tilde is resulted as 2. That means the Boolean elements you can see here, the tilde of 0 is 1 and 1 tilde is 0. But in case of 2, you are observing the 2 is itself repeated. So from the above example, we should note the important points the important points are here. 2 is the only self tilde element. It is the only self tilde element because no other elements are like this. So this we may not have such a basis element in Boolean algebra, because in Boolean algebra we have 0 and 1 are the basis elements. So they are not self tilde elements. So that is the difference between the Boolean algebra and the pre-ester algebra. So 2 is the only self tilde element, and 1 is the meet identity. That means you can see this row, 1 meet any x, 1 meet any element is the corresponding element. 1 meet x is equal to x. If x is 0 or 1 or 2, the outcome is 2, the same element. And in case of 0, 0 is the join identity. That means when you insert 0 join x is equal to x for all x. So you can see 0 join 0, okay, is 0. 0 join 1 is 1. 0 join 2 is 2, like that. So 0 is the join identity. And 2 is the uncertain. That means 2 meet x is 2. Sorry, 2 meet x is equal to 2 for all x. I can say like that. And 2 join 2 is equal to 2 for all x. Even 2 tilde 2. Okay, 2 tilde is like again 2. That means so once 2 is entered, then everything is uncertain like that. So we name that certain element as uncertain element. And you are observing here in the next slide the 2 element Boolean algebra. So in fact, we write the set 2 is equal to 0 and 1. So they are the basis of a Boolean algebra. If you take the example of a Boolean algebra, 2 is equal to 0, 1, the basis elements. So with this definition, we can clearly verify all the 7 conditions of the pre-ester algebra. So from this, we note that the Boolean algebra already the set 2 consisting of 0 and 1 is already a Boolean algebra. So this is a Boolean algebra. That means every Boolean algebra is a pre-ester algebra because they are the basis elements. 0 and 1 are the basis elements. So therefore, it is a Boolean algebra. So therefore, we can declare that every Boolean algebra is a pre-ester algebra because the basis of Boolean algebra satisfy the conditions of pre-ester algebra. Therefore, it is a pre-ester algebra. And other side, you can also see the two element set 0 and 1 is a subset of the pre-ester algebra three element set. That means the pre-ester algebra consists of the two elements 0 and 1 as a subset of this. And further, we should note that the pre-ester algebra 3 is not a Boolean algebra, as there is a significant element 2 which is not in a Boolean algebra. So Therefore, we declared that every Boolean algebra is a Priester algebra, but every Boolean algebra, so every Priester algebra is not a Boolean algebra. So one way is it is possible. Every Boolean algebra is becoming a Priester algebra, but reversely, all Priester algebras need not be Boolean algebras. So that means if you restrict the significant element, then only we will get a Boolean algebra from the Priester algebra. So this is the point to be noted here. And with this, I will take you to the definition of Priester vector spaces. So here you can see the definition of Priester vector space. So to define Priester vector space, first we should consider the additive abelian group. So let V be the set consisting of V plus B, an additive abelian group, and A is a Priester algebra. This V is said to be a Priester vector space over A, or we also name it as A vector space if and only if there exists a mapping. There exists a mapping A cross V to V. That means the Cartesian product of A and V, which consists of the order pairs A comma V, where A belongs to A and V belongs to V. And the result of this is nothing but the like a scalar multiplication A times of V, such that for all U and V in capital V and A and V in capital A satisfies the following conditions. So you are observing the first condition is just like a scalar multiplication, okay, over the sum of the vectors. A dot U plus V is A dot U plus A dot V. Okay, and the second one is A dot B dot V is nothing but A meet B dot V for all AB belongs to A and B belongs to V. And the third condition, if you observe this one, A meet B is equal to zero. That means in the vector space concept, we have the orthogonal pairs. That means if you take the pair A and B, whose meet is zero, orthogonal means zero. So whose meet is zero here? So such pair that satisfies this condition, A join B dot V is equal to A dot V plus B dot V for all AB in A and B belongs to V, and 1 dot V is V for all V belongs to V. And we shall state the elements of V as vectors and those of A as scalars. And the operation A comma V that goes to AB as a scalar multiplication. So this is the definition. And we need to quote some of the important examples in this context. So before going to discuss about the examples, we need some certain supporting results. So in the context, so we derived one important theorem that is nothing but considering a Priester algebra. And from Priester algebra, we are deriving a Boolean Priester ring. Suppose A meet join tilde is a Priester algebra. For any A and B, we define the binary operation as follows. The binary operations, because to get a ring, we must need the binary operations plus and dot. That means the addition and the multiplication, they defined as follows. A plus B is equal to A meet B tilde join A tilde meet B. That is the definition of plus. And the multiplication is defined as A meet B. So by using these two binary operations, so one can verify that A plus dot is a Boolean Priester ring. So this definition seems to be easy, but we faced a little trouble in converting, or we faced a little hurdles. Some hurdles are there. So later on, we cleared the hurdles, and finally, we proved that it is a Priester Boolean ring. And actually, the proof need not to specify, but I am so interested. I have some curiosity to inform you about the proof also. So the commutativity of addition is verified here by taking the binary operation a plus b, how it is defined, and from this we derive this identity, and then therefore this is added to this one. So a plus b is equal to a meet b tilde join a tilde b is proved as okay. So and then we used this derivation, and also reversely we have added, that means as meet and join are commutative in pre-Estelle algebra, so with that we got the concept that the plus is commutative. So later we verified the associativity and the commutativity. Those things are also specified here clearly. The proof is given clearly. I don't need to specify them. And the important thing is the additive identity. So what is the additive identity here? So one must verify. One can verify that zero is the additive identity by using the definition of addition. Already we specified. Already we verified. A plus zero is verified as A, is verified as A, and further you can also see further this point also very important. A plus A meet tilde is verified as A. Previously we verified A plus zero. We verified A plus zero is A, and later we verified that A plus A meet tilde also A. So therefore, so these two we combined, and we can see here a plus 0 is equal to a, as well as a plus a meet tilde is also results the same. It also results the same. So in both ways we are getting the 0 as the additive identity. So therefore from this argument one can take that a meet a tilde is equal to 0. A meet A tilde is equal to zero, the additive identity for each A in A. Normally, additive identity means zero is a fixed one for all in case of real numbers. Zero is the additive identity for all. Okay, so but in case in this case we are specifying, if you take A, the corresponding zero additive identity is for each A, it is mentioned particularly here. And to prove that every element has additive inverse, that means what is the additive inverse, that also we verified here. So by taking a plus b the definition, and by taking b as a, one can verify that a plus a is derived as a meet a tilde. So already this is proved as a zero. So that is the advantage of the above proof that I want to inform you. So a meet a tilde is proved as zero, so that we are getting a plus a is equal to zero. So therefore the additive identity of each a is a, additive inverse I mean. So a is the additive inverse of a. So with that we verify that it is a abelian group. And later on the multiplication is also proved as associative, and the distributive law also verified. And with this we can say that it is a the with respect to multiplication it is a semi ring, so semi group, and already it is a abelian group, and with that we can say it is a ring. After that we verified that one is the identity. So 1 dot a is equal to a is verified, because the dot is defined as in terms of meet. So therefore we verified that 1 dot a is equal to a for all a. So therefore a plus dot is a pre-Estelle ring with identity, and the boolean element we observed as a dot a is a as idempotent. Every element is idempotent, a ring with identity in which every element is idempotent. So that is verified here. So therefore a plus dot is a boolean pre-Estelle ring in which 0 and 1 are the additive and multiplicative identities respectively. And this result we used to define or to give a sufficient a particular example. So the same pre-Estelle algebra and the additive group we have taken. So you can see here the example. So A is a pre-star algebra and V plus additive group of the corresponding Boolean pre-star ring. If you take the Boolean pre-star ring, so we already have a additive abelian group. So we have taken a particular additive abelian group of the Boolean pre-star ring. Boolean pre-star ring, because we have taken the same pre-star algebra and the additive abelian group of the corresponding pre-star Boolean ring, and then we can verify that this V becomes vector space if we define for each A in A and V in V the scalar multiplication AV, that is nothing but the Boolean product of A and V in A, because all the elements are inside of A, so therefore it is a Boolean product inside A. So this is a example of this pre-star vector space, and particularly we derived one more result. We have taken all the the central idempotent elements of any ring. So this is also a crucial result in this manuscript. Suppose R is any ring with a unity element. And suppose that there is defined a subset A of R. So what is that A? A is the set of R such that R square is R. That means the idempotent and commutative. Such an element, such elements are called central idempotents. The elements, they are commutative. Okay, the elements we have taken, they are satisfying commutativity with all other elements. Such elements are called central and at the same time idempotent. Central idempotents we have collected, and the central idempotents collected as A, and on A we have defined meet and join and tilde as follows. The join of AX and Y is defined as X plus Y minus X dot Y, and the meet is defined as X meet Y is equal to X dot Y, and tilde is defined as 1 minus X for all X, Y in A. So by using these operations, we verified that we will observe that the pre-star conditions. Totally, we have 7 pre-star, for a pre-star algebra, we have 7 conditions. All the 7 conditions verified here. So straight away, the verification is done here. So we are getting a pre-star algebra. And now we are using this result to get one more example. So the example is stated here. Suppose the same thing I'm repeating what we discussed in the above theorem. So R is any ring with unit element, and A is the set of all central idempotent elements of R. And from this A, we derived a pre-star algebra by using the operations. Now, this is the background already we have completed, and now how we are getting a vector space from this, if V is a additive group of the ring R, because already we have a ring, here, okay, R is a ring. So in this ring, we have taken additive group, and for any A and for any A in A and V in V, the product AV, okay, the product of the elements A and V in R, then V is a pre-star vector space. So we define the product like this, and this product satisfies the vector space conditions. So therefore, we can get another pre-star vector space from the above theorem. So this is one important example. And another example, all of you listen carefully here. We have taken a set consisting of the power set of any set S. So what is S here? S is any set, and P of S means set of all subsets of S. So we have taken the set of all subsets of S, and meet and join are the binary operations, and tilde is a unary operation. So this is a pre-star algebra of all subsets of a set S, and we have taken a set V consisting of the elements V such that V is a mapping from S to G. S is any set, and here G is a additive group. The set of all mappings from the given set S to the additive group. We have collected these mappings, okay? And these mappings, we use it to define the vector space. So for any U and V, the elements of this set, that means they are mappings from the set S to the group, additive group G, and A belongs to A. So elements of A, what is the meaning of this? Elements of A means they are nothing but the subsets of S. So small a, we should understand that it is a subset of S. And we have defined the mapping, the U and V, they are functions, U plus V over P. So what is this P? This P is any element of S. And A is a subset of S. P is an element of S and A is a subset of S. Therefore, this P may be in the subset A, small a, or outside of A. So this point is very important here. So we defined this as a point-wise addition. U plus V, set of all functions, the sum of the functions defined as point-wise addition. That means U plus V at P is defined as U of P plus V of P. For all P belongs to S, and the scalar multiplication we are observing here, AV at P is equal to V of P. That means here we are skipping A, because if P belongs to A, if P is an element of A, because A is a subset of S and P is an element of S, this may be element, if this P may be element of A, this is the definition. Otherwise, this is the definition. If P is element of A, the definition is V of P. If P is not in A, the zero is the definition. So under this definition, one can verify that P is a V star vector space, that because it satisfies the axioms that we mentioned in the beginning. So this becomes a V star vector space. And we have successfully defined one more example here. And to define this example, we have considered the set like LN of A. So what is this A? A is nothing but the V star algebra. And we mentioned A power N. That means the Cartesian product of A, how many times? N times. A cross A cross A cross A, like that, N factors. So we have taken LN, the set A power N, and we defined the vector addition and the scalar multiplication as follows. Vector addition, the sum of N coordinates defined as the join of N coordinates, corresponding N coordinates. That means A1 join B1, etc. An join Bn for all n tuples in A power N. And similarly, the scalar multiplication A dot B1, etc. Bn n tuples defined as A meet B1, comma A meet B2, like that A meet Bn. That means the n coordinates are getting meet with A. B1 is meet, A is meeting with B1. And A is meeting with B2 like that. Finally, A is meeting with Bn like that. We defined this scalar multiplication. Under these two operations, we verified that A power N with respect to plus is a abelian group, because we have to derive the V star vector space. Okay, so we should verify the abelian group conditions. So that done clearly, the clear proof is given here. All the 82 group axioms verified clearly. And after getting the 82 abelian group, we need to get the remaining four axioms of the vector space. Okay, so plus is here the internal operation, and the scalar multiplication A cross A power N, that goes to A power N, this is the external operation. Okay, so the external operation means the scalar multiplication. So this scalar multiplication should satisfy the four conditions of the vector space, that also verified. So finally, we verified the four conditions, and we derived that the set LN of A, which is nothing but A power N, is a V star vector space over the V star algebra A. And the important what we discussed here is what we derived here, in the above theorem, we derived that A power n is a pre-star vector space. The same thing we have considered here, the vector space again. And again, we defined the operations meet, join, tilde on that set. And we derived that this is again a pre-star algebra. So that is also observed here. So that means to verify this pre-star algebra, we have to verify the 7 conditions. So those conditions are verified by defining the n coordinates with respect to join and with respect to meet, and the n coordinates with respect to tilde, the definitions are given clearly, and the conditions verified, the 7 conditions are verified here. And you can see this ln of A with respect to the 2 binary and 1 unary operation, it becomes a pre-star algebra. And the next thing is the elementary properties of the vector space also verified here. You can see there is a lemma. Suppose V is a arbitrary pre-star vector space over a pre-star algebra. For all V in V, we observed that the zero scalar, zero times of V, is again the result is zero vector. And any scalar with the zero vector is again also a vector. So this proof is also supplied here. And the next lemma, also a preliminary result. So A times of the negative vector is completely the negative vector is also verified here. And with this background, we proceeded for the crucial results. And to proceed for the crucial results, we have taken an important condition here. Hereafter, to facilitate the following results, we consider the pre-star algebra A with the pair of elements A, B satisfy the condition A join B is equal to 1. So if A join B is equal to 1, automatically we can get A join A tilde as 1, and A meet A tilde is equal to 0 in our pre-star algebra. So if the pair satisfies this condition, then automatically we can use these conditions. So that flexibility we can get by taking such a pair. So that we have taken. So that reference also mentioned here. So normally in a Boolean algebra, these conditions holds. A join A tilde is 1, A meet A tilde is 0. But in case of pre-star algebra, we have no such facility. So to get this type of elements, one must take A join B is equal to 1. If we have this condition automatically, we get these type of elements. So these we used at the respective places to get the results. So that is the important note here. And we can see a important lemma here. Suppose V is a arbitrary pre-star vector space over a pre-star algebra, and A and B are the elements satisfying this condition, A join B is equal to 1, then automatically these two conditions holds in a pre-star algebra, and V belongs to V, then the first condition is that A tilde V is equal to V minus AV. A tilde V is equal to V minus AV. And the second one is A join B at V is equal to AV plus BV minus ABV. So the proof is also given clearly to get these two results. So just I am proceeding to the next result. And the next theorem is, suppose V is a pre-star vector space over a pre-star algebra A, and the pair is satisfying, each pair satisfying this condition, A join B is equal to 1, and R is a Boolean pre-star ring, because already we have derived from pre-star algebra the Boolean pre-star ring corresponding to the pre-star algebra A. Then V is an R module if and only if V plus V is equal to 0. So what is the difference between the module and vector space? So vector space we define over a field, and module is R module means it is defined over a ring. So our vector space conditions and the module conditions almost coincide, except one condition, that is if you have such a plus B where A and B are scalars, or they are scalars from the ring R, and V is a vector. So if you take this one, one can verify that this must be equal to AV plus BV just by distributive law like that. Okay, so if you get this condition, then automatically this V becomes a R module. This V becomes a R module, and the condition we need for that is V plus V is equal to zero. So this is a equivalent condition, a necessary and sufficient condition for a vector space to become an R module, where R is the freest, or where R is it, we have taken as Boolean freest ring corresponding to. So this is the thing that we have taken, and we verified for each AB in R and V in V, and we have taken the definition, because in the ring R the plus is defined like this over the elements of A, and we have taken this A plus B at V, and you can see the definition of plus. The plus is defined like this, and from this to proceed this one must satisfy this condition as per the free star vector space condition, orthogonal pair. Unless this is a orthogonal pair, we cannot write this condition. So that is the point to be noted. So after writing this condition, one can verify this this one by simplifying. You will get the corresponding expansion. You can get AV plus BV minus 2ABV. That means two times of this ABV we are getting here. So now just look at this one. A plus B at V is equal to AV plus BV, and this is the extra element. So if you skip this one, that means if it becomes zero, then straight away we get this condition. So therefore, consequently, we conclude that if this V becomes a R module, if and only if this element is equal to zero, that means two times of the same element should be zero. So we generalize that, okay, or equivalently we can say x plus x is equal to zero for all x belongs to V. So that is the condition here. So this is the necessary and sufficient condition to get a R module from a free star vector space. So this is the point to be noted here. And you can also see the next, there is a definition. There is a definition on the norm. So you can see the definition here. If A is a free star vector space over A, so that is said to be the vector space is said to be a normed or normed vector space, if and only if there exists a mapping. So the norm is a mapping from V to A. That means this norm is a function taking the vectors to the algebra A, pre-Astor algebra A. That means norm is taking the vectors to the scalars. The result is a vector. Okay, the result is a scalar. Finally, we get a norm of a vector is nothing but a scalar, such that norm of V is equal to zero if and only if V should be zero. And the second condition, norm of AV is equal to A times of norm V for all A belongs to A and V belongs to V. And so this is the definition we consider for the norm. And also we quoted here the examples we discussed in 0.1.3, also normed vector spaces. One can verify that one. And also there is a important theorem here. By taking the norm, we can derive the following conditions. For any pre-star vector space V, vector space V over A, with the pair A join B satisfies the condition A join B is equal to 1 for all A, B in A, the following statements are equivalent. So what are they? V is normed. That means V is a normed vector space. And to each vector in V, there corresponds an element A suffix V. So you may ask, what is this notation? A suffix V means this is the scalar corresponding to V, a specified scalar. That means a scalar specified to a particular V, such that A V of V is V. Okay, AV of B is equal to V. And if B belongs to A, BV is equal to B, then BAV is equal to AV. And we verified these two conditions here. We verified these two conditions. So, and you can see an application of that one. If V is a normed vector space over A, then we can verify the triangle inequality type condition. Triangle inequality. That means norm of U plus V is less than or equal to norm U plus norm V for all vectors. Okay. So you may ask me why there is a join operation instead of plus, because we should note that this is a scalar, this is a scalar, they are scalars in A. In A, we are having the binary operation only join. So that is the change here. And we verified this condition. The proof is given clearly. The triangle inequality verified. You can see the proof. And in the next, another application is also derived. And if V is a norm vector space, we defined a norm by using the distance. So D of UV is equal to norm UV. So this defines a metric on V. So this is called the metric induced by the norm. What is this? This is the metric induced by the norm. By using the norm definition, we are defining the distance function between the vectors U and V. Okay, so D of UV is defined as a norm of U minus V, and this is a metric on V that satisfies the metric space conditions. So metric space conditions mentioned here, D of UV is equal to zero if and only if U is equal to V, and D of UV is equal to D of VU, that means symmetric. Okay, distance between UV is zero means they are the same. And the second one is the distance between the vectors is symmetric. And here D of UV is less than or equal to D of UV plus D of VW. So this is a triangle inequality. So here is the mistake is there. I hope that you identified the mistake. So this must be joined here, because the distance is nothing but a scalar. The scalar means it is an element of the pre-Euler algebra. So therefore it must be joined here. So please note that this is a printing mistake. This should be joined here. Suppose that all these conditions verified here, and you can see the proof is given clearly, and you can see the triangle inequality. It is also mentioned. The mistake is there here. It should be joined. It should be joined. That is also noted. So while I referred once again, I find this mistake. So there is a mistake here. So please note that we also studied the concept of Boolean semi-ring. So I am referring the definition of Boolean semi-ring here. So a system R plus dot is called Boolean semi-ring if and only if the following properties hold. The first one is R with respect to plus is an additive abelian group whose zero will be denoted by zero. R dot is a semigroup of the idempotents in the sense A dot A is equal to A for all A belongs to R, and A dot B plus C is equal to A dot B plus A dot C, and the product of three elements like this. Okay, so this is the definition of Boolean semi-ring, and we verified that from the normed pre-Euler vector space, if we define the product of the vectors like this, that means the product of UV defined as norm U times of V, then one can verify that V with respect to plus and dot becomes a Boolean semi-ring. So straight away we verified the above conditions of Boolean ring, and we verified that V with respect to plus and dot, what is this V? The pre-Euler vector space with respect to addition and multiplication is verified as Boolean semi-ring. So this is the important observation. And now you can see the important result here. If V is a vector, okay, if V belongs to V, can be uniquely expressed as V is equal to a linear combination you are observing here. where all the V's are in V and they are the A's are the scalars. And if A is defined as A1 join, A2 join, etc., AN, okay, where each, if AI meet AJ is equal to AJ, if I is equal to J, and zero otherwise. That means orthogonal, okay? So idempotent orthogonal, I can say. If they are same means you will get the same element, okay? Idempotent, orthogonal means zero. If they are different means we get zero. So like that, we have taken the pair, with that pair we defined the element A like this, and we verified that that is a duplicator of B such that AI is equal to BAI. So duplicator means like this. You can see here AV is equal to V. That means A times of V, that is again giving V, again giving V. That is the sense here. So we verified AV is equal to V. Duplicator means duplicator of V means if you apply the scalar on V, again you will get the same. Okay, so that is the meaning here. And we verified initially in this condition AV is equal to V. So A is taken as the join of A1, A2, AM as defined in the theorem statement, and V is the linear combination, and verified that AV is equal to V. The proof is given clearly. And suppose particularly if you take some B which is defined similarly as A, so one can observe that V takes the form. And what is V? V is nothing but the linear combination of the elements. And finally, the V is proved like this. Now compare V with this one, and by the uniqueness of V, by comparing both sides, we can observe that AI is equal to BI for all I. So this type of expression we got by using the duplicator of V. Okay, by using the duplicator of V, so we got this type of expression. And they are also defined linearly independent vectors. Set of linearly independent vector also it is defined. So a finite subset of non-zero elements of V, this is called linearly independent if and only if the linear combination equal to zero and A1, A2, etc., they are non-zero, implies that again the sum of the vectors should be zero. And any subset of non-zero elements of V is said to be linearly independent of V if and only if every finite subset of S is linearly independent. And also spans. Spans means every vector can be written as a linear combination. Spans means linear combination. So a subset S of V spans V. If every element of V can be expressed as a linear combination of elements, for all A belongs to, for all G belongs to S, like that. So this is the span definition. And what is basis? Basis means linearly independent and spans. Linearly independent and spans. So that is the point to be noted. And here we have supplied one example, a crucial example. A is a pre-Estar algebra, where A is taken as the set of all subsets of any set S with meet join tilde. So this is a pre-Estar algebra. And V is the set of all mappings of S into the finite subsets of abelian group G. Then V becomes a pre-Estar vector space over S over A, as we defined already in the previous example. And K is the set of all non-zero constant maps in V. We have taken K as a subset of non-zero and constant maps in V we have taken. And we proved that this K is a basis of V. So to prove that basis, one can verify that the vectors are linearly independent and spans. So those things we can verify by taking the constant functions. If the functions are constants, So if you take a linear combination like this, automatically F1 of A1 becomes A1, F2 of A2 becomes A2, like that. You will get directly. Okay, so therefore these vectors are linearly independent, and also we can express every element as a linear combination like this. So therefore K is a basis of P. So this is the observation. We have taken a particular set of constant functions from the above set. Now we can verify another important result here. If V is a normed pre-S star vector space and G star is a basis of V, G star is a basis of V. So basis means spans and linearly independent. And if you take a basis vector G in G star, then we can get the negative of that also. If for every G belongs to G, minus G also exists. For every G, there is a minus G. It is having additive inverse. And if you take any two basis vectors, we can get the sum of them. Okay, the additive inverse we get, and the sum of the vectors also we get. So I think you got this point. Based on these two, we can say that it forms an additive abelian group. This is the equivalent condition. That means every element has additive inverse, and the sum of the two elements again holds. It is closed under addition, and additive inverse holds. Therefore this forms a additive abelian group. So that is the point mentioned here. If G is a basis of V, then the G star is the set of all non-zero elements of an additive group. Okay. So if G star is a basis of V, then G star is the set of all non-zero elements of additive subgroup of V. So that means by above theorem, the result follows clearly. And you can also see the next slide. It is mentioned if you take the vectors, the basis vectors are proved as the norm of such basis vector is 1. This also verified. And if you take a vector with linear span, linear combination like this, for the orthogonal pair of scalars like this, then one can verify that norm of U can be expressed as join AI norm UI, where I is equal to 1 to N. So this type of result also verified. And the proof is given clearly. And finally, you can also see one more result here. If U is a linear combination like this, and with the orthogonal pair of elements, and the base vectors, one can verify that norm of U can be expressed as a join AI, where I is equal to 1 to N. So these are the important results we have discussed. And there are some concluding remarks in front of you. This work made a stand to study vector spaces over an algebra and its useful characterizations as well. A pre-S star space initiated and observed its various representations. An n-factored pre-S star algebra is observed as a pre-S star vector space, and such a pre-S star vector space is also observed as pre-S star algebra as well. The notion of normed pre-S star vector space also initiated and studied its properties. The method of construction of Boolean semiring from a normed pre-S star vector space is also obtained. And it is noted that the basis of pre-S star vector space forms the set of non-zero elements of an additive subgroup of the pre-S star vector space. And I also invite the researchers for further scope of study. So as the n-factored set of a pre-S star algebra is a pre-S star vector space such that, and such a pre-S star vector space is a pre-S star algebra, one can study pre-S star algebraic properties of such a pre-S star vector space, and also the vector's notion of pre-S star algebra as well. Because if you verify that such a pre-S star algebra is a vector space, if this pre-S star algebra is having the elements 0, 1, and 2, so every element of the vector space has a linear combination. So we can express the linear combination of the particular elements 0, how to write 0 as a linear combination of elements, how to write 1 as a linear combination of elements, how to write 2 as a linear combination of elements, and we can study those things. And further, I must note some more points here. And you are observing 2 as a crucial element in this pre-Hessian algebra. What is the physical interpretation of such one? Because we have studied, normally we study algebra and other things without applications. And we should physically interpret how these things are useful in real times. Okay, in real time problems, how they are useful. So I should remark the significance of 2. So the significance of the crucial element 2 in a pre-Hessian algebra is to extend Boolean 2-value logic to 3-value logic. So Boolean value logic is 2-value logic. So that is extended to 3-value logic. That is, if the Boolean elements 0 and 1 stands for false and true statements respectively, then 2 stands for divergence as neither true nor false. 2 is neither true nor false. In case of Boolean algebra, we have to confine our logic to either 0 or 1. There is no other go. But in case of pre-Hessian algebra, so we can have one more step. That means we can have neither 0 nor false cases. For example, in a traffic signal system, you can observe the physical interpretation of this one by a real time application. We can see for example in a traffic signal system, the 2 basic signals, you can see green light and red light, may further extend it to another signal different from green and light depending on particular situation. Yes, this we can see practically. So sometimes instead of green and red light, the other color light we can observe, so that the traffic we follow accordingly, the traffic rule will be extended accordingly. So that is the important observation. And also the similar logic can be observed in washing machines. You can see fuzzy logic control system. So this is also applied, the logic is applying in fuzzy logic control systems. So the present work is algebraic study of this logic. And I also quoted some of the real-time examples here. So you can see some applications here. And because I quoted the applications of linear algebra, so why we have to study this linear algebra, and what is the purpose of the linear algebra in real-time problems? So you can see linear algebra is a continuous form of mathematics and is applied throughout science and engineering because it allows you to model natural phenomena and to compute them efficiently. The concepts of linear algebra are crucial for understanding the theory behind machine learning. The machine learning processor, we can observe, okay, the techniques of the concepts of linear algebra we can use to understand the machine learning, especially for deep learning. So linear algebra provides concepts that are crucial to many areas of computer science, including graphics, image processing, cryptography, machine learning, computer vision, optimization, graph algorithms, quantum computation, and computational biology, information retrieval, and web search. And also, that is about linear algebra, because we studied here in this concept about vector spaces. And further, you can see how Boolean algebra is crucial and how it is important. Boolean algebra, as the calculus of two values, is fundamental to computer circuits. We can use this in computer circuits, computer programming, and mathematical logic, and is also used in other areas of mathematics, such as set theory and statistics. Programs use simple comparisons to help make decisions. So to make decisions, we have to see the logics. And Boolean logic is a form of algebra where all values are either true or false. That means to understand the pre-Hessian logic, one can have the background of Boolean logic. if you are having the background of Boolean logic, you can see how the pre-star logic that can be extended. So I captured some of the applications and I want to share with you. And these values of true and false are used to test the conditions that selection and iteration are based around. And what are the applications of Boolean algebra? In particular, by taking the values, variables represent the represent values of on and off, or 0 and 1. So 0 and 1 means on and off circuits. We use them in circuit theory. Boolean algebra is used to design and analyze digital switching circuitry such that found in personal computers, pocket calculators, CD players, cellular telephones, and a host of other electronic products. So we should understand the applications of Boolean algebra and the logic behind Boolean algebra and the logic behind the PSO algebra, in what way we can extend. Today, Boolean algebra is of significance to the theory of probability, geometry of sets, and information theory as well. Furthermore, it constitutes the basis for the design of circuits used in electric digital computers. And why is Boolean logic important today? So equally important, Boolean logic is today seen as the foundations of the information age, or what we call as computer age. This is because each value in these logic statements or equations reduces down to either being true or false. With zero ambiguity, the logic is binary. If the logic is binary, this is the thing. And if the logic is ternary, okay, binary means two. If it is ternary, 0, 1, 2, so what is the further study? So that we have to focus in this aspect. And what is Boolean logic? You start off with the idea that some statement P is either true or false. Cannot be anything in between. In case of Boolean logic, it cannot be anything. But in case of pre-Aristotle algebra, it can be other thing. You can see either true or false. But in case of pre-Aristotle algebra, neither true nor false. It diverges also. Okay, so this is the point to be noted here. And then you can form other statements which are true or false by combining these initial statements together using the fundamental operations and or and not. And why is Boolean used? Boolean operators are used are simple words, and or not, or and not, used as conjunctions to combine or exclude keywords in search, resulting in more focused and productive results. This should save time and effort by eliminating inappropriate hits that must be scanned before discarding. And this Boolean logic is also used for logic gates. So what is the purpose of logic gates? Logic gates perform basic logic functions and are the fundamental building blocks of digital integrated circuits. Digital integrated circuits. So integrated circuits. So you can see this. This is important, very important here. So integrated in large scale circuits known as VLSI. Okay, very large scale. Okay, integrated circuits. Very large scale integrated circuits are known as VLSI. This is the VLSI is the best real time application of digital integrated circuits. I'm repeating once again, VLSI is the best real-time application of digital integrated circuits. Most logic gates take input of two binary values and output the signal value of a 0 or 1 or 0. Some circuits may have only few logic gates, while others such as microprocessors may have millions of them. Microprocessors. So microprocessors are we can use in computers, and microcontrollers we can use in washing machines. So advantages of logic gates. Logic gates are quick at use low energy. Logic gates do not get overworked. Logic gates can lessen, means reduce the prescribed number of input output ports needed to be microcontroller. So we should note what is microcontroller. Logic gates can bring about straightforward data encryption and decryption. That means encoding and decoding concept. In the encoding and decoding concept also, this will be useful. And I want to stress on this microcontroller. So microcontroller we can use in washing machines and MP3 players. And whereas microprocessors we can use in computers. Okay. So with this, I am concluding my lecture with the references that I have used in this manuscript. So I have used totally 8 manuscripts. And I thank one and all for your kind attention. Thank you one and all. And I thank once again for the organizers. So with this, I am concluding my lecture. Now I am inviting Srinivas Rao.
Thank you so much, Guruji.
Coordinator. Yes.
In short time, but actually, my dear participants, 11 o'clock, Guru Gariki, unko international webinar unde. So that within 5 minutes, even important issues regarding this presentation, everyone has it. So raise your hand and we can ask you. But we need to conclude by 11. Sharply, he is having another international webinar. Now, request from participant side, any important issues? See, whatever the issues which are relating to this presentation, Guru Gar will send, sir, with your request. I'm requesting from the participant side. Most of them, they are messaging me. They want the PPT actually. With your due credits, they will use if you permit. Is it possible, sir? Ah, yes, sir. Sir, PPT, you will try to charge it.
There is no problem. I will share with you my PPT also.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
No problem.
On behalf of participants, I requested Professor. So he has extended his consent to share his PPT so that you can analyze your knowledge. Whatever the queries you have posted, I will send it to Professor Sir whenever he is having time. He will chat with you personally. With this,
and also share my email ID.
Yeah, please.
Share my email ID so that they can contact me personally.
Yes.
And they can share the views. Okay.
Thank you.
Share the questions and all things. So let's share the email ID also.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Through WhatsApp groups, I will share professor's email ID and professor PPT also, so that you can interact with him. Whatever the doubts and clarifications you require from him, so he will clarify. He is at the service. Though he is an international personality, he is having a lot of love on homeland. That is the reason why he has extended his consent. Even though our college is very small college, by accepting him, immediately he said, okay. So I'm feeling this is a kind of services towards my nation. So that is the spirit of our Professor Jonalagada Venkateswara Garu. Thank you so much, sir. I'm bowing my hat to you. So with your blessing, today's webinar is a great success. Thank you so much. RJD sir is also so happy with this mathematics webinar. He is a dynamic personality in mathematics, sir. So he also extended his cooperation, and my CC is always there with us to encourage this kind of webinars. The mainly my principal, I would like to say my beloved principal, he is the man behind me. He is always motivating me. He is always encouraging me to do this kind of things for the purpose of public service. Thank you so much. With this, we will conclude with my principal's closing remarks. I request principal sir, with your words, we will close.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir, for a wonderful presentation of Jonalagada Venkateswara Garu.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you again. It's a very good opportunity to our students and the staff, lectures, who interested very, very good information about mathematics, a rare information about the math algebra. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Srinivas Rao and our standards, and particularly about Vinila Department of Mathematics, to good support to cooperate the conduct of webinar. I think the number of webinars to conduct, many more webinars to conduct in this in our college. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Sir Guru Garu, thank you. With this, we will conclude. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Ananda.
Thank you.